And the reason I say that is because you're damn right I want Gwen to come back, you know? I mean, for obvious reasons, but you know, as far as Gwen as a coach, I think that's what I need to bring the most attention to. There's never been a coach that represents the style of music that Gwen does. You know, she has a background in ska music, we all know that, and then she was able to transition from that into pop music, and I guarantee you nobody in this room can really compare her to anybody else. And that's what's important about her as an artist to the music industry, and that's what's really important about her as a coach on The Voice, you know. And I'd like to sit here and tell you that, you know, I'm a powerful guy, but I had nothing to do with her coming back as a coach. That has to do with people way above me, and obviously we were both excited and high-fiving and partying about it when we got the news, but that's because Gwen is special, you know, and she deserves this.
And that's I think the hottest date here tonight, Gwen Stefani, who's sitting out there.
Question, Valentine's Day is just around the corner. Who would you say is more romantic, you or Gwen?
You know, I would say, you know what, forget it, I'm going to say me.
What?
I think I'm more romantic.
Take control.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you have planned?
I will say Gwen's a sucker for romance. It's yeah, she makes it fun. We've said this to each other before. Gwen and I have fun literally no matter what we're doing, whether we're on vacation, at a party, you know, going to the grocery store. We have fun, we laugh, and that's why it's so much fun to be with her.
She looks amazing tonight, by the way.
Oh my God, she looks incredible.
Seriously.
I mean, what the hell? I feel like, you know, like the fat ugly guy in high school that got the hottest girl in school to go to the prom with him. That's what I feel like.
Well, you are the people's choice, so you take that home.
That's right. This fat ugly guy won album of the year.
It is literally shocking how beautiful she is. It's shocking.
I want to start with Happy Valentine's Day.
Thank you. You too.
And I saw on Instagram you got some flowers.
I got some flowers. And it was funny because I was like, wait, there's no card. I was like, wait, who are these from? I was like, maybe Revlon sent them to me, or maybe the cowboy sent them to me. So it was, I love getting flowers, but.
Did you figure it out? Do you know who they're from yet?
They're from the cowboy, yeah.
Okay, well, I didn't know.
It's time to put them to the test with our Who Knows Blake Better quiz.
What's Blake's middle name?
Shelton.
What is Blake's middle name?
Tollison.
Ding, ding, ding.
You didn't know that?
Guys don't know other guys' middle names. Come on. Guys don't talk about that. What's your middle name? Mine's Noah.
Is it?
What is the name of Blake's current tour?
The Gwen Stefani Love Fest.
I didn't know that he named this one.
Blake Shelton for Chicken and Biscuits and Gravy and Good Times Tour.
That's right. No.
Really?
Doing it to country songs.
What is it?
Doing it to country songs. What is Blake's shoe or boot size?
Oh, gosh.
Oh, you know
small.
This.
Small. All right.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Just a different perspective being back and listening to all the music, and I have such an amazing team, and I love this guy, and aww, I love Alicia Keys, and obviously I love Blakey, so it's so fun. I love it here.
Boyfriend.
For Gwen, you guys have had a duet together. You've performed it on the show.
Why don't you do it? Why don't you do it, baby?
Is there going to be more collaborations the fans need to know?
I hope so. I mean, I'm definitely, obviously, open to that. I'd love to write another song with Gwen.
Home with them.
Do you and him team up on an alliance at all? Do you think they do?
Yes.
Yeah?
I think a little bit. I ask him for help. I mean, we do talk about it, like, on off days. Like, we'll be driving home, and I'm like, do you think I should put these two people against each other? And they'll be like, oh, yeah.
And all of a sudden, she's like, wait a minute. I'm talking to you about this. What am I doing?
I was like, I don't believe you. I feel like you're trying to trick me right now.
Is there consequences? What happens when you go home after something like that happens?
Well, she's sleeping on the couch. That's what happens. I'm telling you right now.
I'm sure that
she will be in the doghouse.
If I could win something by cheating, I wouldn't want to.
I like you even more now.
Blake is different.
He likes me. What if he like tried to like cheat to make me win? Like to be like, oh, you won. Good for you.
Blake's different
than
me.
And then that, I was like going to get mad about that.
He's manipulative.
You're scaring me.
No, you're good. No, you're good. I'm talking about like with competition.
Okay.
Not with like love.
We love seeing Gwen and Blake back together, hugging, laughing, high-fiving. It's pretty fitting since you found love on this show.
Aww.
It's
kind of
nice.
But it's been, it's what, you know, certain people you come across in your lifetime and it's just like an instant, like, chemistry, friendship. And so he's, I mean, I don't think there's anybody that doesn't meet Blake that doesn't fall in love with him. He's such an incredible person and just funny and just such a good person.
And it's just, it's such a gift.
Plus you're dating Blake Shelton, which is so weird for me. I can't,
I'm so lucky.
What do you see in that guy?
What are you talking about? Greatest guy.
He's a good dude. He's a good
ever.
Dude.
You love him.
I love him.
You love
him. I love you more.
He loves you.
Gwen Stefani,
so,
thanks.
It's been really fun. Obviously, like any time I can be around Blake is you know a blessing. So as much time as possible.
What did you do to get Gwen to go on that first date? Because I needed your help back then. So maybe you can help people right now that are watching. What was your, did you use a pickup line or just go, I'm Blake Shelton?
That doesn't work.
It doesn't? I would think that would work.
With Gwen Stefani, that doesn't
okay,
work. Because she's like, really?
Really?
I'm Gwen.
Who?
Stefani. It's just hard, you know? I mean, we're all busy. But when she came back the second season, and at the time, had just gone through my divorce, and she was about to start going through hers when the show started, we definitely had a connection at that point because we were both, you know, on the bottom, you know? And just, you know, needed somebody to talk to that we could relate to, because not only were we both going through, you know, a horrible time in our lives, we were also knew that we were going to be going through it in the public eye, and that mm-hmm. takes a completely different, you know, level of, you know.
It seems like you guys are having so much fun.
We do.
Like the relationship just seems like you guys never get mad at each other, and I appreciate that, and I love the humor that you both have with each other. And
we do, but she and I, we have... She is my best friend, mm-hmm. and it's crazy how it happened. Circumstance made it happen, I think, to force us to get to know each other. But and it just shows you how some things are meant to be. You know, it's just. But we do. We have so much fun together. You can tell.
Like I love being here so much.
Has America's insatiable appetite for your whole situation, has that calmed down? Because it seemed like it was out of control.
God, I hope so. Please, I hope so.
It got to a really pretty crazy point. Do you think it's mellowed out a little bit since you're on the air and you're together and it's...
I don't think it's mellowed out, really. I mean, I think we don't pay as much attention to it anymore. We're numb to it. I mean, anytime you see a story about us, it's either that it's a fake relationship or that we're already married or we're going to get married or she's on her second set of twins or, you know, I'm sneaking behind her back to eat meat. I eat meat right in front of her face.
Every single one of those things is true.
In people's defense, I think it's so hard for people to wrap their head around why Gwen would want to be with me. I don't blame them.
Here.
I don't blame them.
You're crazy.
You on Snapchat. This morning I saw you hit the gym with Blake. How did that go?
It was good. He killed the gym this morning.
Well, there's a photo, right?
I'm gonna need to see that.
It's so funny because he's so tall that like literally no sweatsuits fit him. So he always has floods like and with the white socks between and he's like.
I feel like you'd be there for 5 minutes and be like, I'm having a heart attack.
he really kills it. It's fun. Yeah. I actually wasn't
going to. My arm is numb.
It's because of him that I worked out this morning. I wasn't going to work out. So.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, he's my trainer.
I get hurt every day. My back hurts. My knee hurts. Everything.
Yeah.
She got in there. I mean, look at like to be born with her genetics.
Dude,
I mean,
great.
My God,
yeah,
she doesn't.
Great.
I mean, my God,
that's good.
It's not fair
because so many kids their age watch, but I guess because it is us, it's sort of like they're like they don't watch. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah,
they are into Blake's tattoos. I saw what happened Easter Sunday. That's fun.
Well, they're just into him. He's who isn't
kids.
Like
they're not true.
Only kids could be into those tattoos.
Hey, aren't you supposed to be there? Right,
yeah, your girlfriend and I are having a blast, actually.
Oh, speechless.
We're excited.
We're kind of matching. Did you notice this yet?
I feel like we're at prom right now.
And we're like,
yeah, I love
it. Do a prom pose quick before I let you go.
Aww.
Blake, you jealous?
Yeah, Blake, what's up now, bitch?
I got your girl on TV.
Thank you, guys. Great to see you. Have fun. Ooh, they're coming for you, Adam the Sirens.
What would shock people about him? Probably his knowledge of music, like broad knowledge outside of country music. It's pretty crazy. And just how gifted he is as a songwriter and as just a singer and just... And then how much he just lets it all roll off, like he doesn't care. Like, that's really shocking to me.
Or the fact that he has three balls. What?
That's... Hi, balls. Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm here with Adam Levine.
Hi, guys. You know...
Aren't you proud of me?
I had a good feeling. I felt like I was the luckiest guy in the room anyway because Gwen is here with me, so I had a good feeling about it.
You looked amazing at the Billboard Awards last night. I was in the building. I had a chance to see you. I loved Blake's little shout out. Felt like the luckiest guy in the room.
The winner of the whole country thing. I was so proud of him. He deserves it. I mean, he is the real deal. So.
How was Gwen?
She's great.
Yeah.
She's, you know, she's sad that the voice is over and she loves doing the show.
But how is she with you? I don't care about the voice.
Well, I hope she's good with me. I'm real good with her.
Y'all happy?
Yeah. We're just content and happy and it's just a...
So on a typical day.
It's an incredible feeling.
Typical day, no work, no concerts, no nothing. What do you and Gwen do?
Like our hobby is just hanging out together, you know? She's my best friend. Oh, no, don't start that.
No, that does.
Come on.
No, that does. You know what?
Is that wuss? Did I say something completely wuss?
No, you didn't. You know what happened? Your eyes went really soft when you said it.
It did?
It's real.
Your girlfriend is always, Gwen, is always so well-dressed, super fashionable. Does she ever give you advice on this?
She really doesn't. I think she probably just feels like it's a lost, hopeless cause. You know what I mean? She just kind of is like, oh, there's that shirt that you wear every day. So it's clean, so you're gonna put it on today again.
That'll be nice. I see you guys come down here all the time with the boys.
We have so much fun. I don't think you should be able to have that much fun. It's probably not legal in California.
Some of the other songs are I Lived It. I think that's gonna be tomorrow. And then Turning Me On, I'm sure some of you, if you follow the gossip out there, you've heard of Turning Me On. That's a song I wrote with my girlfriend and mine.
Getting her out on the water, if it's too hot, she won't even get out then, you know? So it's like, you gotta have the perfect day to get Gwen out there, but when it is the right day, it's harder to get her off the water, you know? We love to get out there and just float around, you know? We don't fish, we just hang out together. It's a good view when Gwen Stefani's in the boat with you. It was one of those, you know, it wasn't planned. I just said, hey, we're doing this video tomorrow, you know, and it's a wedding and there's families there. I said, you guys want to come be in the video? You might as well be extras, you know, it might be fun. Of course, yeah, let's go. And there's, you know, Gwen still has that part of her where it's like, oh my God, you know, that mother like, oh, my kids will be in a video. That'll be fun, you know, so she got to dress them up.
And you're on a Christmas song with Gwen. This is cool. You guys... Yeah. I mean, definitely, you come from such different genres. What is it you love most about working with her and that vocal blend?
Gwen blows my mind. I mean, she's one of the greatest songwriters, I think, of a generation. And the way she goes about it, how honest, how painfully honest she can be with her lyrics and how warm she can be when the subject matter is something like this. You know what I mean? I don't know how anybody else who's been able to be so honest as a writer and just, you know, lay it all out there. And so being able to work with her on that level it's been great for me to learn from her. And outside of that, if I'm going to be singing, you know, to somebody, looking into their eyes, how awesome is that for me that I get to do a duet with Gwen Stefani?
That's awesome. You make her feel like Christmas.
Yes.
That's awesome.
You know, I'm obsessed with Gwen Stefani, right? We've talked about this.
Trust me, I have seen your meltdown.
It's pretty major. I'm unabashed.
We're still supposed to go to Africa together, right? You have this.
We are going to Africa on a girls' trip.
Okay.
We're not sure when it's going to happen, but it's pretty soon.
Oh, she talks about it.
Does Gwen fish at the lake house?
You know, she has gone fishing before, but it's one of those things where it's like if she hasn't caught something in 5 minutes, it's like, well, what else is there to do?
Yeah. So what else does she do? I want to make her happy when we go to Africa.
We like to just float. If we go out on the water, we get out on a pontoon boat and just
float.
Float around.
No
kidding. Yeah. Talk.
Do you ever sing to each other?
What Gwen, the hell are we, the Partridge Family or something?
Gwen likes it when I sing to her, so I was curious. Does she like it when you sing to her?
I don't know. I guess. I hope so. I hope so. We don't really... We talk a little bit about music.
But not much.
No, that was the... You know, we get plenty of that in throughout our work week.
Yeah. You've turned into a proper farm girl now. I mean... You really have. You know what? I feel like my nature growing up was Orange County, like the beach. That was our nature. That was it, you know, and which is beautiful and incredible. But to be able to experience middle of America and the gorgeous Oklahoma, I mean, I know, it's like, it is very beautiful there. And Nate, what? It is beautiful. She sends photos of her. When you're not on an ATV, you like, they have a boat and they go on the river and it is, I mean, it's a totally different kind of slice of landscape. I actually wrote a Christmas song while I was there. I went off. What a coincidence. Like you do, you know, when you're jogging around in Oklahoma. but it is so pretty, and I love going there because I feel like it's so, I get to do nothing, and I never get that here in LA, so. Yeah, but it must have been a little bit of a culture shock, though, the first time you went. Blake is a culture shock, yeah. That's for sure. Blake is a culture shock.
But you did, you love Turning Me On. You clearly, this is like a special song to you. Is the reason that it's in there on the album?
What are you trying to dig
at? The one song. Well, I just wonder, is that because
what are you doing to me?
Because it's like that one that you were like, I gotta give one to Gwen. Like, I gotta do this on this album. This has to be on there. From me.
Because I feel like even these that I didn't write that are pretty much directed towards her also. So it's not, I was just proud of that song.
We saw the picture of the kiddos dressed up like you. That
Stop
is
it.
Awesome.
I died.
Gwen's kids dressed like Blake?
Yeah, we got to teach them there's a higher standard they should hold herself right. up to. And there's been times where, you know, Gwen's a pretty good artist as far as her drawing also. And the kids want this horrifying tattoo.
It gets worse every year. It gets worse every year, I think.
It does.
Yeah. I don't know if it, like, your forearm gains weight and loses weight a lot.
Yeah, of course it does. Look at this. Look at my head. But it. I don't know what to say about it. It sucks. But then the kids want that tattoo about twice a year. So she'll spend an hour or so with a Sharpie painting on the tattoo for them.
Mm-hmm.
I had most of the day just sitting on my bus with nothing to do by myself, and so I grabbed a guitar, and for whatever reason I started playing that little acoustic signature lick of the intro, and then I just started singing this line, Turning Me On. You know, obviously there's no question what I was thinking when I was coming up with the song, and I was thinking about Gwen. She wasn't there, and she's just she's magical. That's the only way I know to say it.
Like a man.
Earning legions of new fans as a judge on The Voice, where at a difficult time in his life, he met the woman he says gives him hope.
Talking to Gwen Stefani, he's going to be on Gwen Stefani's team.
People even in my own life that said, man, I really can't figure the two of you together until I saw it in person. It makes total sense, you know. She likes it here. It's a relief for her to be able to come someplace that she doesn't have to look, you know, around the corner at every building to see who's taking her picture and following her car. You know, this is an area where you do that, then you're going to get some friends called on you.
They're going to look out for her.
That's right. That's right.
My favorite Gwen Stefani song. I like a lot of her songs, and I really like her last album. But I think I got to go with Underneath It All.
When we found out what each other were going through, this instant bond that we created, unspoken, and it's still there, of like this unified front. That's what's most important to Gwen, is somebody who has her back and is a best friend. And that's kind of how it started. And it just kept snowballing and snowballing into, you know, what it is now. And it's, and it just feels like it gets stronger all the time.
Rumor, he might be people's sexiest man alive this
what?
Year.
Uh-huh. Oh my God. Uh-huh. Well, wow, they got that right.
I was gonna say, I need to know.
I knew I was onto something.
You had the right idea. If he is, what's the reaction if you wake up and that's the news?
Wow, I'm gonna look really good, huh? I already had scored, but now I've really scored.
There you go. And is there like, what's the reaction if he's not?
Oh, well, I still score. I think somebody that can make you laugh constantly important. Is very sexy. And somebody that is, let's see, humble, kind, down to earth, selfless, talented, on the top of their game. I think I'm his biggest fan.
Hey, this Christmas is gonna be the best that I ever had. Now I know what they mean by love. I finally know what they mean by love.
Wow. You That's memorized powerful. It almost.
I have. I was singing it this morning. Blake better be very, very flattered.
Yeah. Blake's currently playing stepfather to Gwen's three boys, age 3, 9, and 11.
You know, there's days when you go, oh my God, when does school start? And an hour later, you're going, God, I can't wait till they get home. They're so damn funny, you know? She and I, on paper, we couldn't be more different. In life, nothing's ever worked better for me.
But Gwen must be thrilled now. They're gonna hardly pay attention to her when you walk in a room. They're gonna go, oh, Gwen was here too? You know, that's good.
You know, I feel bad for her, you know, because she has been in the spotlight and this, you know, this yeah. symbol of beauty.
And now you're overshadowing.
Gwen has had no influence on your music. Have you made her a little more country? Is it worked the other way around? Have you influenced her more?
I don't know. You know, she's only made one record, you know, since we've been in this relationship. I know she's a huge country music fan, you know, and mostly the old school stuff, you know, but she listens. That's what she listens to when she drives around. It's pretty cool.
Blake's ego is fine. He's a very humble person. Mine, though, on the other hand, now I am my boyfriend, which is even weird to say, is the sexiest man alive. So I knew that, and I knew I was onto something, but now everybody else just happens to know. But I'm really proud of him, and he's my best friend, and it's just a magical time. We wrote a song on this record together, a Christmas song. We're huge Christmas fans, so it's just been like a really exciting thing to have his record come out and then have this come out, and you know, doing something together that's a song that is so joyful. It's like, it's exciting.
That your mom and dad are still married, like my mom and dad. Would that give you the confidence to have another go at marriage?
What?
Would you one day, or?
At this point in my life, I'm literally like anything
just
can
loving
happen.
Life.
Yes, I'm just trying to live in the moment too, because it goes by so fast.
But if Gwen and Blake do get married one day, will Gwen's last name be?
Shelton or Stefani?
Wow, that's the topic of the day. Two S's is good, right?
Sounds good, yeah. S and S, that's S good. S. I like that.
I don't know. Merry Christmas. I think that right now I'm really just trying to indulge in really living in the moment and being present and not thinking about the future and what's going to happen. But I am very grateful to have Blake Shelton as my best friend. It was actually Blake's the one that sent me this voice text message. He's like, oh, I was thinking about your Christmas record, and I don't know, I was sitting on the bus and I just came up with this. And he just like sends me this text with this like hit Christmas song on it. I was like, dude, like what a jerk. Like you just sit around writing hits, like you're that talented.
And sexy.
But we ended up getting to write a song together and sexy. but yeah, and then I ended up using that as the title. I was like, I'm just gonna use Blake up as much as I can for this Christmas thing. So he basically was like thinking about the record, and when I told him the style and the direction that I was gonna do it in, he was sitting around on the bus and he started, I guess, playing on his guitar and came up with this, I wanna think, this film. He came up with this whole melody and sent it to me in a voice text. I didn't even know he was thinking about writing a song with me. Well, I think to write an up-tempo Christmas song is hard. You know, it's really hard. I think you can write those slow, like moody ones easily, but to have something that's so fun and up-tempo and has so much love in it, I'm proud of it, and I'm really, really happy to have him on my record.
You should
I had this idea, because I remember praying in my bed when I was like 8 years old, like, who am I gonna love? Like, who's that gonna be, that fantasy? And I wanted to put that into a song, so that I wrote a song about that. I just, you said you could relate to that. Yeah, I know picture. We all did yeah. that. We were like, yeah. who's it gonna be?
Yeah.
It was Blake. And now like, I don't know if I've done it, but I wrote a song with Blake Shelton, who is a country singer in America. He's incredible and he's the sexiest man alive right now. If you haven't noticed, he's.
Have we got a picture?
No, we haven't. No, but you can just Google his name. But anyways, we wrote this song together. It's like a duet, and he wrote part of it. I wrote part of it, and it's just like an unlikely, you know, coming together of our voices. But
well, lots of people will be putting their trees this weekend.
I got by the way. What was the best gift you've ever received?
That's a good question.
Like, first of all, buying something for Gwen Stefani, it's like, you know, it's for anybody really, but you know, some your friends and your family, they have to be like, okay, what do I get Gwen? Like, what's the best gift?
I have so many special memories. Blake gave me this beautiful bracelet last Christmas, which has all my kids' names on it.
That's stunning.
It's ridiculous.
That's beautiful.
That's one of my favorites.
What it is, but I'd never been to Oklahoma in that kind of way. Like, I've toured through there, but you don't see anything. And I was like, I don't really like dirt really that much, you know what I mean? I'm not really into that, like, you know? And so I guess he freaked out because his lodge is like a big man cave. There's not, it's not like a house, you know what I mean? And it just goes from that house to dirt, right? And so it's like dirt. And so anyways, he built, I guess he went crazy, like putting a whole slab like in of concrete so that you didn't have to walk into the dirt. And he built like this overhang thing. And then he took, I guess, secretly pictures of everything in my kitchen, like, and then sent them to his assistant to have, so when I got there, I would have like, you know, a blender and a coffee maker and like all everything like exactly the same at my house. I was like, so I guess he was worried, but I think it was very much like he wants me to like it so much, because he likes being there. So
that's so sweet, though. That's really thoughtful.
People magazine cover, and everyone's taking it so seriously. And it's like, if you think about it, I mean, what defines sexy? It really is so personal. You know what I mean? And for me, it's just that big old heart and that sense of humor and just such a, you know, he doesn't even like take himself seriously, and he's just so such an incredible person.
Yeah.
So
yeah. It worked out. That's sexy.
That's sexy to me. It is.
It's really interesting because y'all got together at a time that you met each other at a time in your lives, both of you, that you really got each other. But do you think, like, years ago, if you would have met him, that y'all would have gotten together?
I still can't believe that.
I mean...
No.
You wouldn't have gotten together with...
It actually does work out good. Yeah. You look at those two pictures. You should put them next to each other.
Yeah, well, we should. There.
Oh!
You ask and we'll do it.
That is perfect. It is perfection.
Yeah, you'd get all up in that.
Oh, my God. You're crazy.
That's what we love about him and what we love about you. And it's like you guys seem so non-Hollywood, so not about that stuff.
I feel like, well, I mean, I think that we really enjoy, like, doing music and making music and sharing it and performing it, and that part of it we really do love, but we also love, I think, just the normal part of life, which is hanging out and eating cheese and, like, pizza and, like, sitting with our kids and, like, and being able to go to Oklahoma really, like, is another layer to that because it's so, like, so much downtime there.
Deep into the soil, you know.
And it's just earth.
And to have three boys, three on a ranch and a farm is so different from growing up in California.
It is.
It's
our nature was beach. That's it. Yeah. That was our nature. And so for them, it's just, it's freedom. Like, we had our cul-de-sac. That was our freedom. Like, that was our freedom.
And he doesn't write very often. Uh-huh. Like, that's the one thing I'm like, you are so talented. Like, why do you not do that more, you know? And I think he knows that I really want him to. So he kind of sent me this voice message, and it was this whole long explanation about how he's just sitting around and he had this idea and I don't know if there's anything here, but maybe you do something with, and he's like, and he basically sings this whole like song. It's and I'm like, whoa. I was like,